Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. Finally finished with this godforsaken Cloakwood area. Well, the second Cloakwood area, full of spiders who poison you and kill you. And then inside here was something called a sentiole, which is actually turned out to be female. And was in love with John Arrhenicus, but he cursed her, and yeah, well, we put an end to her misery. She actually asked us to kill her. She could have at least told the spiders to leave us alone, but I think the spiders really listened to John Arrhenicus, not her. They fed her and kept her there, and basically, yeah. How could she not die of boredom is beyond me, because it looked like she's basically so obese, unable to move. It's, yeah. Pretty horrible fate, and I was going to run all the way back. I'm still going to do it off screen, even though it looks like, duh, I found a way to get Minsk unencumbered, at least partially unencumbered, or slowed, because we have to return this guy's, the body of his son, Chelak. Apparently there's someone else we need to find in the Cloakwood Forest as well. Purwell. Hunting down a wyvern. I don't know where we'd find that. Tiber. His brother entered the Cloakwood in an attempt to destroy a spider infestation. That must have been that sword we picked up. I have to identify this sword. Someone's holding it. Yeah. Two-handed sword. So, let's return this to him.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Excuse me, please let me speak before you attack.
I'm not gonna attack you. I'm trying to get rid of 185 pounds of this corpse, sorry. Chelak, oh Chelak, how will I ever tell my mother I was so stupid? This is brother, not his son. I should have stopped this stupid idea. Such a waste. Such a waste. You can keep the damn sword. It's been more of a curse than anything else. I thank you for bringing my brother's body. There was little you could have done. Okay, so it is brother. Good. Drop the body. You earned experience for recovering Chelak's corpses in the Sentiole's lair. Tiber gave us the sword known as Spider's Bane. Okay, so we already had a sword, and here's another sword, I guess. Or did he? It doesn't say we gained it. I guess we still... I can give him... That's right, I took that off because I was messing around with the weight and stuff. I know he was still carrying it. So yeah, I guess this is the spider's bane sword. All right, we need to go raise our friends, and I'm gonna do that off screen. I'll see you guys back when we're ready to identify these items. Okay, so we're getting tired here, but we have two things to identify. I never memorize these so I can identify both of these things and then switch my spells back and figure it out. This has got to be the same as the other one, Wand of Frost. Don't ask me why I can't just identify that, since I've already identified one and I've been using it. But anyways, another Wand of Frost with 12 charges. And this thing, Spider's Bane +2. This sword was originally forged by the dwarves of the Orathiar tribe in Cloakwood. They created the blade to help foster goodwill between them and the Grand Dukes of Baldur's Gate. Wielded by the Grand Dukes for about a century, the sword was eventually lost. Ironically, in a fight against Ettercaps and spiders, who wields the blade is now unknown. Not anymore. But its recovery would aid greatly in fighting the current spider infestation that plagues the Cloakwood. Protects the wielder from any magics that affect movement, such as hold and web. That's awesome. It's a two-handed sword. So I guess Mintz could use it and have it put his other two swords in inventory. That's it. I don't know if we're going to be... Well, that's not Minsk. I don't know if we're going to be encountering any more of these things. Because you cleared out that area, but... I'm sure we'll at some point. So that's it for that. So, sleep. Alright, time to rest. Let's see if we can buy anything.
Why me?
You know, at some point I ended up... Someone must be wearing this. I don't think it helps with anything. So you might as well sell it if you'll buy it. You know, we have the other one that... Branwyn's been helping about. Caring about. I've distributed some potions around. Discipliner. Oh yeah, this is that cursed one. It's interesting, you can sell cursed things for money. I mean, I guess it's useful if you want to trick somebody. Here's a plain old girl. Sell it. That's the one that she... Yeah, that's the girl that we have. So, that's it. Oh, didn't we have one spell to spell scroll?
You are right, Whiskey.
I think we had one spell scroll to sell. Flaming Hands, if I remember right. Shocking Grasp. I stand corrected. Much better.
All right. Why me?
So I guess we're keeping that. Yeah, look at all the arrows we've gotten rid of. Still have plenty though, but we just had to drop them. I couldn't manage carrying this stuff around. Yeah, give him some, because he does have a bow. At least I think he was carrying this bow. Weapons are good. It's a sling plus one and a sling plus one. Okay.
Why me?
Why not? So we don't need to go to Thunderhammers this time. I'm not completely sure where to go. I mean, there might be another section of Cloakwood that we haven't been to. Yet we have not been to this Cloakwood. Alright, so there's bandits in one of these.
Why me?
All right, let's follow the river. Oh, who's this? Eldoth? Isn't that the one that someone's looking for? Eldoth sounds familiar. Hidden base in the Cloakwood. That's Entar. Perwell. Perwell is the one the bandits have kidnapped, so it might be the same bandit camp that has him as well. Yeah, I'm not sure. Eldoth sounds familiar. But I don't know who he is.
Sure.
Gentlemen, gentlewomen, may I introduce myself? I am Eldoth Kron.
Sorry if I seem out of breath, but I had to retreat from a battle. I was ambushed by a dozen gnolls farther back on the trail. I guess that's them. I handily dispatched them, but thought better of fighting their half-dozen ogre friends. I guess that's the half-dozen ogre friends. I think I've evaded them for now. Would any of you care for a drink of some fine Zagauntian brandy? Sure, there's enemies coming, but give us some booze. Hope you're enjoying your liquor. It is some of the best you can find. All of you are probably wondering why I'm being so generous. Obviously not from the kindness of his heart, you think. Well, in a way, I am. You look like the type to be on the outlook for ways to improve the quality of your life. Well, I have a proposal that could help you in that endeavor. You see, there's a girl, my lover, in fact, who desires to escape her father and live on her own. Her father is Entar Silvershield. We're looking for him. One of the Dukes of Baldur's Gate. This, of course, makes her desires more difficult than that of the average city girl. However, with your insistence, we could help her escape the tyrannical clutches of Entar. Here's the punchline. Since Entar is going to be hunting us anyway, we can blackmail him for hordes of cash and not worry about our captive escaping. After all, we're doing it all for the sake of Skie. Now, we needn't go about this right away. In fact, I'll help you with whatever you're doing until you decide to head up to Baldur's Gate. Just think of it as one favor deserving another. Not gonna tell him this, but if he wants to join our party, I was still full. Sure, we could use the extra help, and your scheme sounds like it could work. I'm glad you're all savvy enough to recognize a good opportunity when it comes. I don't know about this guy, one says. I mean, his scheme isn't all that terribly bad or anything, but I get the feeling he's not telling us everything. I think you're right, Imwin. Shall we go? We shan't. Alright, we got Dread Wolves. Oh, these aren't the ogres. You agreed to help Eldoth with an extortion plan. He wants us to kidnap a young girl named Skie, who happens to be the daughter of a Grand Duke Entar Silvershield. Kidnap? I thought she was coming of her own free will. Eldoth has told us that Skie wants to escape home and would be a willing partner in the scheme. Well, then it wouldn't be kidnapping, would it? Once we have her, Eldoth will blackmail Entar. Well, I mean, okay, so I thought these were ogres or ghouls, but obviously none of the above. If we can only do that with him and our party, then I guess we're not doing that. It is a pity. Victory! Our time together has been thoroughly charming. Perhaps we'll meet again. We're kind of busy right now, guy. He's just standing around. Oh, just making sure she's attacking.
Tempest, give us victory!
Tired. Because it did take a lot of... The journey took 2 days and 8 hours. No wonder we're tired.
I don't want to talk.
Too tired to talk. Let's go over here.
Why me? Damn forest. Always reminds me of Pansy
Elf. Good job. Such menial tasks.
Full plate and packing
if
steel.
If Tempus wills it.
Alright, let's try to rest. See how it goes. Good.
All right.
Oh, he's still here. Oh. So somewhere there's some ogres? Half ogres? I don't know. We'll fight them. He either said a dozen or a half dozen. Okay. It's a bit of a smaller area than the first Cloakwood, at least. Looking for a bandit hideout. Hope we don't run into thousands of friggin' spiders. But if we do, we have this cool sword, at least. Clearing the fog of war as far as we can. I'm not sure if it's a very big river or a lake or something. A black bear. Just going on our way, Black Bear. A bridge. See if there's anything else on this side first. We're running out of land here. Looks like we gotta go cross that bridge. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. And we got to it.
Good for you to watch your actions while in this wood.
Oh yeah? Who's this? Laskal? You there! I command you to stop, so that I may parley with you a moment. Who are you? What is it that you want with us? My name is Laskal, and I am the protector of the Cloakwood. I would ask you a question before I take my leave of you. I have a message for those that serve the Iron Throne. Would you be a representative of that organization? Okay. If he's the protector of the Cloakwood, then I don't think he would be a friend of the Iron Throne. So, it's either or. He's a protector of the Cloakwood, delivering a message that he's going to attack us. Or he's lying, and he's actually a bandit. At which point, if we tell him no, we're sworn enemies, then he attacks us. And he might warn them somehow. I wish I had a third option to say, maybe? He seems intelligent enough. Here's a message for those that serve the Iron Throne. We have no connection to that evil group. We are sworn enemies of the Iron Throne. An enemy of an enemy is a friend. My earlier question was just a test. Oh, good to know. I am glad to know that you also oppose this organization. They have been a blight on these woods ever since they reopened the ancient dwarven iron mine. Well, I am glad to know you. Take this. Hopefully we'll aid you against the Iron Throne. The Iron Throne's fort is located to the east. Dinah here says, so thou styled thyself an enemy of the Iron Throne openly now? Well, one cannot hide all in a sack, I suppose. So mayhap 'tis for the best. Farewell. We gained a potion of invulnerability. We already had one of those. Yeah, I'm saving it. Basically, it's not really invulnerability, it's just saving throws plus 5. And it can be only used by... what do you call it? Warriors. Or warrior types. Saving throws here. 11, 13, 12, 13, 14... Oh, he's got horrible. Yeah, I say have him keep it. He's got these other potions, though.
Good on you if you saved the day.
Actually, wish we had more quick item slots. To the east. Alright, so I guess that way. Would be east. Let's check out the rest of all this then. Oh. Cave bear. And squirrel back up. One cave bear. No stragglers, not allowed. Glad we got
bunch of chumps. What the hell do you think you was doing?
Kind of glad we got away from the water. It's starting to rain now. What's this? Faldorn. Hail.
I am Faldorn. I have been looking for those who would fight for the sanctity of this forest.
Evil men have been defiling the woodlands with smoke and waste, all in a futile quest for the metal, iron. Would you join me in my task? I would destroy these men of the Iron Throne. Come with me. They dwell to the east within a fort. We don't have any free slots. Your lack of concern for this forest's suffering is disappointing. I'm sorry. A girl named Faldorn has told me that the Iron Throne's base is located to the east. Would that we could have you all join us in one huge army.
Civilization seems far, city dweller.
Who's this? Takiyah now?
Go past us! Alright!
Take not another step. I would know your purpose in this wood. Tell true, lest you feed the trees from below. Interesting way of putting things. I hunt those that would defile these woods. Bandits are my quarry. A noble goal. and one that my fellow Shadow Druids will no doubt support. You should have an escort, however, just to make sure you do more good than harm. I recommend you speak with Faldorn. She will gladly share your fervor in exterminating those that poison these woods to the east. Go now and seek her aid. I've already spoken. A druid named Takiyah. I didn't see Sentiel's story, and I can't see what this guy was saying. Oops, sorry about that, guys. When we charmed the huge bloated creature that called herself Sentiel, we did not charm her. We threw a fireball at her. We were told an interesting story. It seems she was cursed to her current shape by a powerful mage called John Irenicus. The exact role of Tanova is unclear. Journal updated, hidden base in the Cloakwood. Okay. Okay, here it is. A druid named Takiyah has told me to find Faldorn. Faldorn is on a crusade against a group that poisons the forest. These people dwell to the east. All right. Well, we already talked to her, and that's okay. We are full of people. Well, oh, there's a cave or something there. That's interesting. A wolf. Oh boy, a bunch of wolves. And us all split up and stuff. Radwin getting hurt. It's alright though. What's in the base of this huge tree? So we had three Cure Medium wounds before. What is this? Treehouse. Let's go explore.
All right.
Didn't think he'd be that thrilled about it.
All right.
Nobody here, apparently. Okay, a quarter staff, a plain old sling, and 6 gold. That's not Emmeline.
Alright, alright.
Okay. A potion of freedom. That's the potion I was looking for before to use against the spiders. Free action. Get through those webs. And a potion of healing and an antidote. That's cool.
Full plate and packing steel. Butt kicking for goodness!
Good job.
There's a Kagan picking up.
Alright.
Four. He's got these bigger ones. These are 27. Or should I save them? I think I'll save them. So 4 and 3, and then... Potion of Freedom. Just in case they come across more spiders.
Sure.
It would be good for you to watch your actions while in this wood.
Huh. Amarand. Who dares presume to trespass upon nature's territory whilst a shadow arc druid looks on? Who could be so hungry for death? More of Senyad's weakling pawns, no doubt. How he can be one of the three with his pacifist attitudes is beyond logic. My apologies, but we are hunting those who would destroy nature. Is there a bandit installation near here? You seek to destroy that which those heathens have built? Perhaps you warrant temporary passage, then, though you shall be under my scrutiny. You will find a human fort if you continue north and then go east. It is inhabited by defilers who call themselves the Iron Throne. It will be best if one of our own accompanied you to be sure that your intent is true. Seek the one named Faldorn. She will join your cause. Her rage at those who would defile this land can barely be contained and will no doubt benefit your cause. Go now. Do not tarry in places you do not belong. The Iron Throne base lies north and then east of the Druid Grove.
Why
it
me?
Would be good for you to watch your actions while in this wood.
Pardon my ignorance, but what is an arch-druid? Ignorance is never to be pardoned. Lessons hard learned are the ones best remembered. I shall enlighten you and then pose my question again. I am an arch-druid of the Shadow Druids. Oh, so is you, the arch-druid. Or arc-druid. One of the few with my level of experience, and it is our duty to purge nature of outsiders. Druidic orders that think people can exist alongside nature are doomed to fail. We shall restore nature to its former glory, the only way possible. Active aggression. So again, I put it to you. Who are you to dare trespass in nature's territory? I seek those that have polluted this wood. They are barely worthy of the title bandit. And he says the same thing. Just out of curiosity. I know we can't pick our lock, but...
By thy Valkor's mighty blade.
Sure.
Can I take this for the cause? I didn't seem to mind. Is that a chest? Special bullets. I might be able to identify those just by having them. Bullet plus one. There you go.
All right.
That's empty. He just lets us take whatever. That's cool, though. Oh.
Why me?
Good on you if you save the day.
All right.
Or steal the stuff. The case may be. Alright, north and then east. But I want to explore this whole area first. If we stumble upon it, an attack we shall. That's a pretty cool little treehouse over there. What else lay within these trees? We can't even go that way. Another cave bear. Oh, this is the top edge, okay. I guess it'd be all the way to the north, northeast over here. Not sure.
Don't mess with nature, oh. Or it'll mess with you.
Hello? You have the audacity of an ogre mage the way you strut through this wood. Well, you'll not get much further than this if your purpose here does not counter the damage you might do to nature. Who do you claim to be, and why should I let you pass? I beg of you, let me pass. There are villains in these woods that will do it more harm than I. I must track them down. You display the same fervor that drives the other shadow druids and me. Perhaps there is merit in letting you continue. You might even prove useful. There is an infidel in a cave to the northeast of here who dares to capture creatures of the wood and bend them to his petty purposes. No doubt you would like to see him fed to his captives as much as I. Please proceed and dispose of him at your leisure. Thank you. I was gonna do that anyway. Izefia. How many of these people are there? Was in a cave here. Oh! Infidel in the cave northeast. That infidel right there. Okay. So we'll check out that cave. He captures creatures of the woods and bends them to his petty purposes. So we're going to be fighting creatures of the wood, charmed animals kind of thing. So I can use this. Animal summoning. Oh, no, I can't use it. Who can use it? No fighter, mage, thief, or barbarian. That's pretty much all of it. Maybe Mince can use it? He's a ranger, not a... Inadequate intelligence. I'm sorry, Mince. That's sad. So no one can actually use this thing. Poor Mince. Oh, a cleric, though. Cleric wasn't included in that. Cleric can use it. Alright.
What is your command?
Alright, good. We'll summon 8 animals that have 4 hit dice or left. Whatever sort the caster names when the summoning is made. The types of animals that come depending on the surroundings of the caster at the time of the spell. That's interesting. The cleric can use it, but the rest can't. And remember, we've got a wand of monster summoning, and we've got a wand of frost. You know what, though? I'm going to use summoning there. There's this wand of fear. Well, we've got this wand of fire. Yeah, let's get our fire and ice thing going here. Sweet.
I need an ale.
I'm afraid there's no ale nearby.
Sure.